is the Thriving Dentist Show with Gary Takas, where we help you develop your ideal dental practice, one that provides personal, professional, and financial satisfaction.
Welcome to another edition of the Thriving Dentist Show. I'm Gary Takas, your show host. Today, we have an awesome interview with my friend, Brandon Rodman. Brandon is the founder and CEO of a company by the name of Weave, and we are going to talk about the latest technology related to your telephone in your practice. And we have some awesome tips on how we can use that telephone to better deliver customer service to your patients, better retain your patients, and create a better experience for your patients in your practice. But before we get to that interview, we have another top clinical tip from Dr. Leanne Brady.
So for today's top clinical tip, I want to talk about a technique that I learned many years ago from one of my mentors, and it's my trick when a patient calls me after hours and they have a temporary crown out. And we always think about maybe sending them to the drugstore and they can buy some temporary cement. And as dentists, as I say that, you're rolling your eyes because they're hard to use and they're messy and patients never get the crown back on the right way. And so then you're thinking, I've got to come in, I've got to put the crown back on, or if they leave it off, the tooth is sensitive, the tooth could move. Well, you probably have never thought about this because I had never thought of it until someone told me, Elmer's school glue. So good old-fashioned white school glue. So first of all, it's FDA approved as a food product. Why? Because who uses Elmer's school glue? Really tiny human beings that are under the age of 10, and they put everything in their mouths. So it's totally non-toxic. You can actually consume it with no negative effects. It also is super easy to buy. So your patients can get even a little travel, those little 30-cent bottles at Walmart. They can buy it at any drugstore, any convenience store, any supermarket. Elmer's school glue is every place. So that makes it super convenient. And patients are accustomed to using it, so that's helful. And when it dries clear, so that's a bonus. So what I tell my patients to do is just to practice putting the crown on with nothing in it, because it's like a puzzle piece, and you need to figure out which way it goes in. And once you've practiced, then just take a Kleenex tissue and just fold it up into a little square, bite on it so that it dries the tooth. Take the crown, put a little blob of Elmer's school glue on the inside of it, remove the Kleenex, put the crown on your tooth, and then just bite on it, and it'll take about 15 minutes for Elmer's school glue to completely dry, and then you can go back about your business. And so the other great thing about Elmer's is it will not irritate the tooth. No one will ever get a pulpal irritation or excess sensitivity. And it's super easy to clean up when they come in. It just peels off the prep and it peels out of the inside of the crown. So I know right now you're thinking this is crazy, and some of you are Googling school glue to see if it's really non-toxic, but I've been doing this for years. And it's phenomenal, the amount of relief that you can sense in a patient's voice when you're on the phone with them after hours with their temp out, and you can give them a super easy solution that they can do on their own is worth it, because they feel like they're not bothering you. They can relax. Their tooth will be fine. It's just a phenomenal little trick. And I actually think it's a better product than a lot of the temporary cements that patients can get in the drugstore, or that we can buy to send home with them in case their temp comes off. So next time you have a patient call you and you're not sure what to do with their temp out, remember, white Elmer's school glue.
If you're a regular listener to the Thriving Dentist Show, you know that I am passionate about helping dentists reduce their insurance dependency. The most important strategic decision that Paul and I have made as owners of LifeSmiles is reducing our insurance dependency. That has made an absolutely incredible difference in our practice. Recently, I've been receiving lots of emails about specifically how to do that. And I've decided to release a digital course called Busting Loose from Insurance Dependence. This will be a 4-week digital course starting Tuesday, June 5th. In this course, I will literally cover everything you need to do to reduce insurance dependency in your practice. I'll walk through a step-by-step program of all the things that we did and things we've done with practices all over the country to help you successfully reduce your insurance dependence. Would love to have you join us for this digital course. To get more information, visit thrivingdentist.com/free, F-R-E-E, thrivingdentist.com/free. Don't worry, you don't have to attend this course live. It'll all be available digitally, and it'll be available 24/7, 365. There'll also be a lot of information for your team members, especially when we talk about verbal skills and how to communicate with patients as you go through that transition. Really looking forward to delivering this course and helping more dentists bust loose from insurance dependence. Well, I mentioned earlier that my guest today on the Thriving Dentist Show is my friend, Brandon Rodman. Hey, Brandon, how are you?
I am doing great. How are you, Gary?
Oh, man, I am doing fantastic. It's great to hear your voice. We saw each other a few months ago, but it's always great for me to hear your voice.
I love chatting with you, too. You're one of the nicest, happiest, and smartest guys in the business of dentistry.
Well, I feel the same way, Brett, and you are one of dentistry's awesome rising stars, and the things that you're doing are absolutely amazing with your company, Weave. And we're going to talk about one of my favorite topics, which is the telephone. So, Brandon, can I frame our discussion really quick? I think you're going to agree with this, but we didn't talk about this ahead of time. But I think you might agree with this. May I go ahead and frame our discussion today?
Absolutely. Go for it.
So I do this live when I'm speaking. I ask the audience a question. And the question is a trick question. And the question is, what is the most important piece of equipment in your office? And imagine a group of a couple hundred dentists. And Brandon, imagine how they might answer that question, right?
Absolutely.
They might, you know, they start to say things like my CEREC or my laser or my CBCT. And every answer, I shake my head no. And then it keeps going a little bit deeper. You know, I tease them a little bit with no, keep going. What do you think? The most important piece of equipment in the office. So, Brandon, we didn't talk about this ahead of time, but somehow I think you might get it right. What's the answer to that question?
I think you're leading me here a little bit. I know it's not the CEREC. I'm going to go out on a wild limb here. I'm guessing it's the phone.
Ding, 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 ding. You got it right, Brandon. And, you know, what's interesting about the phone is it's the conduit. I want our listeners to really get their arms around, at least today, you know, as we're recording this in 2018, the conduit, the phone is the conduit through the vast majority of connection with our patient happens through the phone. Now, that may change in the future with online scheduling and so on. I mean, online scheduling is not new. That's been around for a long time. However, the utilization of it is infinitesimally low. The phone is really our conduit to our patients. And, you know, you shared some great information with me. And if we think about it for just a minute, let's think about the phone for just a minute. Really, what was the last innovation? Before some of the things that you guys are doing, what was the last innovation with the phone and when does that date?
So those innovations, there has not been much in a long, long time. You've got voicemail, which was sure. Amazing at the time. You've got call waiting. You've got multiple lines, but that's about it.
But there, most of that was, we're talking decades old for exactly. The most part.
Yep.
And you are doing some, we're going to get into this in depth in our interview, but you're doing some amazing things and I can't wait for our listeners to learn more about how the phone is just such an opportunity for us to grow the practice and do some really cool things. Brandon, before we get into a lot of the nuts and bolts, would you be kind enough to share your backstory with our, you actually have a really great dental backstory. I know it, but I want our listeners to know it. Would you share your backstory with our listeners?
Yeah. So when I was younger, I grew up in a household that my father had his own construction company, and my mom worked in a deli at a local grocery store. And so when I was in middle school, my mom decided to go back to school and become a dental hygienist. And so I grew up really in my formative years going in to the community college where she was getting her degree from and having her work on my teeth. At the same time, when I was in high school, I had a lot of friends whose parents were dentists and orthodontists. And I saw them during spring break, my friends coming back from spring break with, you know, really great tans because they went to Hawaii, or they'd come back with really great stories because they went on amazing trips. You know, we really didn't do a whole lot of stuff like that growing up. And so as I'm growing up, I'm thinking, wow, these dentists and orthodontists, they make so much money. Like they get to take their families on these crazy vacations. And eventually they only work, you know, 3 or 4 days a week. Like what better family job could there be? So it made sense to me logically. Fast forward to college. I'm at Brigham Young University taking a preview to dentistry class, and I shadowed a dentist I think we had to shadow him for 4 hours straight. And luck of the draw, I found a dental office that was in a basement, no windows, old clientele, really old dentist. And at that point, I said, I don't think I can do this. This isn't like what I thought it was going to be. And so that was my backstory of dentistry, and up until starting my first company in the dental industry called Recall Solutions.
Talk about your pathway in dentistry, because like I said, I know the story, but I want our listeners to know it. Talk about how Recall Solutions was sort of the beginning of this path that brought you to where you are today.
So in 2008, when I started Recall Solutions, we started that company under the idea that there are tons and tons of overdue patients in every dental practice across America. And there's so many of them, and it's one of those things that's just not fun to do. A dental office, you know, employees, team members aren't coming in early in the morning thinking, I can't wait to get on the phone and schedule some overdue patients today, people that haven't been in for 2 years. So it's just not one of those things that's exciting. But we saw it as an opportunity that there's all of these patients that these dental practices have seen. And so we started a business around that. We would literally get a list of all of the overdue patients from a dental practice anywhere in the U.S. And we would call those patients at a convenient time for them, calling them in the evening hours to schedule them for their next appointment. It turns out it's easier to get a hold of them when the dental office is closed.
Sure.
Because patients are at home. And so we would get on the phone, we would schedule them. This was back in 2008, remote access software where you could access your, you know, front desk computer from anywhere in the world over the internet was still relatively new.
Right.
But we utilized that so that when we got a patient on the phone, we could schedule them directly into the appointment book for that dental office. And over the course of a few years, we had called, it was over 300,000 overdue patients for hundreds of practices around the U.S. We had scheduled over 30,000 of those patients for their next appointment. And we had also updated the records in the books for those dental practices, letting them know which patients had moved, which ones never wanted to come back. And we're able to provide that service for all of these offices.
What a database of experience. I mean, 300,000 calls. I mean, wow.
Yeah.
I suspect you learned something there.
We learned a ton. So I always talk about this. At that point in time, I don't know if there was anyone who, over the course of, you know, a 2-3 year period, that had called more patients to, you know, specifically try to schedule them than we did. Mm-hmm. So I felt like we had some insights with all that data on how to be more efficient scheduling, how to be more effective, all of those things, which ultimately led to where we are today. And I think we'll get into that discussion here shortly.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting. I made the comment earlier about retention and reactivating patients. You know, it's funny. When I lecture just about every Friday, Brandon, somewhere around the country. This Friday, I'll be in Anaheim. Last Friday, it was Orlando. But I'm speaking pretty much every Friday somewhere. And I interact with the audience and talk to them during the breaks and talk to them after the end of the meeting. And many dentists will tell you, if I only had more new patients, my practice would be much better, right? And I'm sure you hear that as well.
Oh, we hear it all the time.
And I'm not dismissing the need for quality new patient flow. Would you agree that quality new patient flow is a very important element of a thriving practice?
Absolutely.
Yet, that doctor says, if I only had more new patients, I kind of feel like in most cases, they want to roll the red carpet out the front door to welcome new patients, but they've got the back door wide open.
Exactly.
Right. So I like to, you know, think about this as obviously audio. So I want our listeners to kind of think of that graphic and imagine rolling out the red carpet out your front door to say, welcome. We'd love to see new patients, but then literally having the back door wide open. So I'm going to put you on the spot here. Brandon, why should practices focus more on retention rather, you know, than putting all the attention on new patients? Why is retention so important?
So this is just a simple business principle. This is not unique to dentistry or the medical field. We, you know, at Weave are susceptible to this exact same principle. There's two things a business needs to do. One is get new customers or new patients, which, you know, we've talked about that.
Sure.
But the other thing, this is the only two things a business needs to do. Get new customers, keep your customers. So if you do one and you don't do the other, you're not going to run a good business. And everyone always tends to think of, if I get new patients, that solves everything. It does not, because if you cannot keep them, you are spending a ton of money to acquire these people, and then you're not actually realizing the profits from those people you've brought in. And so you have to make a conscious effort to make retention just as sexy and as critical to the business as acquiring new patients. Because one without the other leads to an unhealthy practice.
Well, I love the way that you've framed that, Brandon, because I believe that absolutely. And you're right, it's not unique to dentistry. It's very common for every business to have that same issue, to attract new, in our case, you know, we're going to use the language patients instead of customers.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah, no, but I love the business reference, because literally, you know, this is, you know, the challenge with cell phone companies, you know, Verizon or T-Mobile or whatever it is, you know, they want to attract new customers, but they often need to work on their retention of existing customers as well. You know, when I first saw a demo of Weave, I want to say this goes back probably 3 years ago. One of the things that I absolutely loved about your product/service, because I think of it both as a product and a service, is that I'm a big believer in a relationship-driven practice where we know our patients' names, we know their spouses' names, we know their kids' names, we know their hobbies and interests, we know the dog's name, and we know, you know, important events in their life. And I believe that that's an important element of a thriving practice, to really have that connection with your patients. And Weave allows you guys, allows the office to have a connection with their patient that really enhances this relationship-driven practice. Can you talk a little bit about what Weave is, number one, for our listeners that aren't familiar with it, and how your product/service enhances a relationship-driven practice?
Yeah, so I mean, from a high level, what Weave does, it helps you communicate more effectively with your patients. And the point of that communication is to strengthen your relationship with them. If you have a strong relationship with your patients, that increases your retention of those patients. And it solves that second part of that fundamental business principle: get a patient, keep a patient. And so the backstory of Weave and what we do originates from that first company that we were calling and scheduling patients all across America. And we realized a couple of things. One, the experience using dental software has always been, dated. It's not a great experience. It takes a lot of clicks to get somewhere, to look up information. And when you need information and you've got a patient standing right in front of you, or you have them on the phone, you don't have all the time in the world to say, can you hold on a second while I look up your next visit date? Or you want to find out what their spouse's name is and when their next visit is, or if they're overdue, or if there's birthdays coming up. There's just a ton of information that's needed. And so what we ran into is we were on the phone trying to schedule a patient in a household. We would schedule that patient and then get off the phone and then realize, oh, there were four other people in the household that we should have scheduled, but we couldn't get to the information fast enough.
It's there. I mean, the truth is the information is there, but it's so layered and it's so deep. And you're absolutely right, Brandon. I can't, in a busy office, we can't, tile through, 14 windows to get to the information that we need. It doesn't make sense.
You simply don't have the time, and the patient doesn't have the patience to sit there while you go through everything.
Yeah.
And so our aha moment was, we will be so much better at scheduling if all this information just popped up automatically. So I knew everything about that household. I had a task list, a to-do list pop up in front of me when I get on the phone with that person. And so we built that internally, but then realized I think dental practices everywhere would like, when a patient calls in, everything that is relevant to that household pops up automatically. So one of the key features of Weave is we integrate with the practice management software and we provide the phone service. So when a call comes in to the dental office, everything about that household pops up. So you've got the head of the household that pops up. You've got every single family member and their ages and genders and names. Everyone pops up. So you know that whole household immediately. That means if you have a new employee, a new team member starting that morning, they can answer the call and they can answer it as if they know that whole entire family and they've been there for years.
Yeah, this is music to my ears, Brandon. I love it. I remember when I first saw your phone, your screen pop. I'll use some industry jargon. We'll tell everyone what they. But when I first saw the screen, I'm thinking, oh my gosh, this is so amazing. This is the information I've wanted all along. It's there, but it's buried, and now it's right there on the screen.
Yeah, and we don't just stop at the who is in that household. We then create a task list for that individual call. And we're looking through every component of that family. We're trying to identify, does anyone in that household already have a scheduled appointment that we should either try to confirm or at least remind them about? Is there anyone in that household that does not have a scheduled appointment or is overdue? We list those people individually so you know exactly who to schedule. Are there any birthdays coming up in that household that you should be aware of and maybe mention on that call? Does that family owe any money to the business? We create all of these things on the fly for that call automatically, so there's no reason to look things up, and there's no excuses on that call to not answer the patient's question and then go into scheduling and confirming appointments.
May I amplify one of those features that you just mentioned, Brandon?
Of course.
So the idea of a patient with an outstanding balance, we see this all the time. And let me give you the example that we see. We've estimated the insurance benefits based on past history. We file the claim electronic. We do our best job to estimate the insurance benefits. But, of course, the insurance company doesn't want us to have that information, so it's hard to estimate it precisely. And we may end up with having a relatively minor balance, like a $8.25 balance. You know, so now patient paid their copayment or the estimated copayment. We filed the claim electronically. We got the check from the insurance company. And now there's an $8.25 balance. And that's such a nuisance, Brandon, because if I have to, if I don't have technology like Weave, then I've got to send a statement out, all the related costs with that, and have further time go by to where now it just becomes an increased cost and a nuisance. But if I have the information on my screen, if you were my patient, I could just say, hey, Brandon, I happen to notice there's a minor balance from your last appointment. It's $8.25. I could take care of that today by phone for you. And it's done right there.
Yeah. So, Gary, I don't know if you're aware of a feature that we have in beta right now, which even makes this way easier and convenient for the patient. So, so doing it on the phone, that's great. You have the information, ask for their credit card, you know, take care of it right then. But still, you know, as consumers, as people, there are technologies that we enjoy using that a lot of businesses and specifically dental practices have not utilized yet. And that's text messaging. So text messaging is a huge part of what we do, but we are in the process right now of in the beta process with a new feature called text to pay, which on that phone call, when you're talking with the patient, you could literally say, hey, do you mind if I send you a text message real quick? You just click on the link in the text message. It'll have the invoice in there for you for the $8.25, and you just pay it through text message. It's super easy because that patient might be driving. Right. They might be doing something where they can't pull out their credit card right then, right, but they get the text message, they click on the link, and we have had, we don't have very many offices using it, and maybe by the time this podcast is live, that feature might be live for all of our customers. But we have had tons of people absolutely love this feature. It makes getting those incremental payments extremely simple and convenient for your patients.
And the patients love it as well. I mean, it's just so easy. I mean, you know, the truth is most people don't really respond to snail mail anymore. And it's just an antiquated way to handle business where this is so much better.
And people pay it right away, too. It's amazing. You know, you send mail and maybe half of it gets looked at.
Right.
You send a text message, over 99% of text messages get viewed.
Right, right. So I think of Weave as the phone, the progressive phone service for dentists.
Think of it as the smartphone.
Ah, okay. There you go. I was struggling with descriptive terminology. So think of it as the smartphone for the office.
Yeah. And imagine going from, you know, the flip phone to an iPhone or an Android phone. It's a world of difference. And you can even go further back than that. Remember the big brick cell phones?
Right.
Imagine going from that to an iPhone. That's what it's like going from a Comcast, AT&T or Verizon, whatever that local phone company is that most dental offices are paying for. Imagine going from that to the iPhone. Right. That's what it's like going from, you know, their current phone company to Weave.
And so some of our listeners must be thinking, well, this must be complicated because I have to find the phones and this sort of thing. You actually provide the phones.
Yeah, we've streamlined the whole entire process. So when you sign up with us, you don't have to buy any hardware. We actually give you brand new phones completely free. We help you get those installed. We take care of all of that and we get you up and running. So it ends up being probably one of the slickest and easiest phone companies to sign up for out there.
And I think of traditional phone companies And I'll just be really candid, Brandon. There's not much love for traditional phone companies.
No, there's not. No. So Comcast, multiple years running, was the most disliked company in America. Mm. So
I believe I cast a vote there at one time for that very dubious distinction. But you, on the other hand, are greatly appreciated by your dental clients because of all the cool features that you provide and the way you provide technology in such a seamless interface. So cool. Hey, let's go back to retention for just a minute. Do you have any data on the value of bringing a patient back into the practice and retaining them? Do you have any data on that? And I have anecdotal data on what it means in our practice, but curious if we can help our listeners understand how valuable that is.
So I'm not going to have the detailed and up-to-date information that you have, but what we see is, you know, and this varies from office to office. You're going to spend hundreds of dollars to acquire a brand new patient. If you only see that patient once, you might get lucky and break even, but you're probably not going to break even on that first appointment. And you've got to see them multiple times over. And the whole idea behind acquiring new patients is to see a 5X, 10X, or 100X return on that patient. And if you can't see a return, and you've got a leaky bucket, if you can't retain people, you know, keep your patients, you shouldn't spend a lot of money acquiring patients because you're not going to make money. And so we've really, really focused on building those tools to remind you to take care of those existing patients. So a lot of features built into Weave will help you know who's overdue, who needs to be scheduled and contacted. We've built automated features to help ensure those patients show up for their appointments, to reschedule them down the road. It's such a critical component. And we believe that as a company ourselves. So it's not just about acquiring new customers. We have to keep them. And it's something you've always got to be working on as an organization, as a dental practice, as a company, is how do we improve this and become a better practice at treating our patients in a way that they want to come back.
Right, right. I'd like to introduce a term that I learned from my friend Fred Joyal. And so I want to give Fred a shout out and credit for that. But it's the lifetime value of a patient.
Yep.
And think about that, Brandon, for just a minute. What is the lifetime value of a patient? Well, of course, there's a lot of variables. It depends how sophisticated the services are that we provide. It depends whether you're in a real stable area where people, you know, don't move. They stay there over a long period of time. But it's really not very far-fetched to think that the lifetime value of a patient, think about a patient that comes into your practice at 30 years old. And hypothetically, let's say you're in an area that is relatively stable and people tend to stay there. They don't move around. That patient could be a patient of yours for 20, 25, 30 years. And when we think about the value of that patient, it's really not far-fetched to think that the lifetime value of that patient could easily be $20,000. And that's really without a lot of exotic treatment. That's relatively, normal treatment provided over a long period of time for a wonderful patient. And so when you start to think of the lifetime value of a patient as something as maybe $20,000 or north of that, it really makes us want to focus more on retention, doesn't it?
Absolutely. And there's two things here that I wanted to point out. One, most dental practices do not really understand how bad the retention rates are. So we did a survey a few years ago of all of our customers, and we found that some of the best dental practices were retaining only slightly over half of their total patient base. Mm-hmm. So you imagine, every patient you bring in, you're only keeping half of them. So you've got to double your patient acquisition cost because you're only retaining half of them. And that's if you were a good practice. So
that's an expensive model of doing business as a dentist, isn't it?
Oh, totally. And so, but you got to be aware of that. If you want to run a good practice, you've got to pay attention to those little things, because those little things will kill you down the road.
Right. You know, I teach our clients to track that, to track obviously the number of new patients that they see every month, but also to track the number that they lose out the back door every month. And very often that ends up being a net negative number. In other words, they're losing more patients than they're bringing in, which is really kind of a emblematic of a practice in decline, not a growing, thriving practice.
Totally. And the second thing that I was going to point out is most dental practices have thousands of patients in their database. And if you've been around long enough, you might have 10,000 or more patients in your practice management software. Now, there's no way when you see someone every 6 months or 12 months to remember everything you need to about that household, about the family members, about the patients. And fortunately, technology is advanced enough that technology can help power a lot of that. Because one of the things in order to retain patients is you got to make them feel like they're known, that you care about them. And I've met, you know, countless dentists that have amazing memories and somehow know every one of their patients, but that doesn't always trickle down to the rest of the team members, which probably aren't as invested in the business. They're not going to be there as long. So when you churn out one team member that may have met, you know, 1,000 of your patients, you now have to bring someone else new in and hopefully get them up to speed immediately, which is an impossible task. And that's where utilizing certain technologies, you know, like Weave, can help bring them up to speed almost instantaneously.
Yeah, you know, you think about it, it could be the doctor or maybe an office manager that has a long history with the practice. They've got all this information in their head, but if it only exists there, it's not giving value to a new team member, is it?
No, not at all.
Yeah. Yeah, I love the way you help our team members become heroes by providing them information. Now, obviously, that team member has to have a good customer service orientation, but I would argue that anybody listening to this is going to have team members who are interested in good patient service. You know, now we've got a team member that's interested in delivering a great, you know, customer service experience for patients, and he or she has the technology to make that happen. Brandon, I'll identify you as a fellow nerd, and I'm using that as a term of endearment, because I am one too.
I love nerds, and I will happily take that moniker.
Yeah, I will as well. There was a time when it was derisive, but today I use it as a badge of honor. You're a nerd. I'm a nerd. I love technology, but I love the way you make this technology accessible. For example, without naming names, there's any number of companies out there that provide ways for us to communicate with our patients via text message, via emails, and so on. But you're the only one to utilize the phone, which is a very interesting strategic decision. Why did you decide to go that route with the communication system with the phone?
So I would love to tell you it was part of a grand master plan. We knew from day one exactly what impact it would have, you know, 5 years, 10 years down the road. But the truth, the real story behind it, is we were scheduling patients with that original company, scheduling overdue patients. We were on the phone talking to hundreds of thousands of people, and we just felt like we were in the dark ages. And the idea of having phone service, the information that you needed would pop up automatically at the exact time that you need it, almost magically, just seemed like something that was cool. And so we simply pursued it because it just seemed to make sense. It seemed to be cool. Well, the things that we didn't know, you know, the naive nature of that view was actually probably the greatest benefit at the time. We didn't know how difficult it was to build phone service. We didn't know how hard it was to raise funding to get investors behind a story that included phone service. And what we've learned today is there's a reason why there's no one else really doing this. phone service is one of the messiest, hardest, most difficult things to build. So, I mean, you can literally look at your cell phone right now, and the majority of the listeners will not have full bars. And that's after these cell phone companies have pumped billions of dollars every single year into their network. So it's that difficult. At the time, we thought it was cool. Today, we realize it's game changing, and that, you know, our goal is to get Weave into every dental practice across America, simply because they will be a better dental practice and provide a better patient experience if they have the information at their hands immediately.
Yeah, you know, I absolutely echo those sentiments, Brandon. And, you know, I like to say the technology combined with a really good customer service culture in the practice is unbeatable, is absolutely unbeatable. In fact, it's really insulation against future changes in our profession. You know, whether it be, you know, corporate dentistry coming to town or, you know, other competitive challenges happening. If you are connected with your patients and you have this amazing technology that allows you to be efficient, you've got an unbeatable combination for the future. It's really insulation that will allow you to continue to thrive and succeed as we go down the road with future changes.
Yeah, I mean, think about the businesses you interact with. So you want to interact with people you like, people that feel like they take care of you, you know, that, you know, it's that component that gets us going back to businesses. And, you know, that component needs to be stronger in the dental industry.
Yeah.
So,
well, and you're part of the trend to really improve that as time goes on. Brent, I'm going to ask you to get your crystal ball out. I'm saying this figuratively because I know you don't have one, but imagine you have a crystal ball there on your desk. What do you see changing in the future in terms of trends of communication in the dental field in particular? What do you see kind of coming down the pike with technology and changes related to communication and dentistry?
Well, I think the best way to answer that is you just need to look at what technologies are being utilized in our personal lives, because those technologies need to be used in the dental industry. So text messaging is something that's not new, but very, very few dental practices are using text messaging in the way that we use it in our personal lives. Meaning most people don't want to get a phone call. They don't want to try to listen to a voicemail. And if they try to call you back, they might be calling when you're closed. So you have to have other forms of communication in order to really communicate with your entire patient base. There's a time and a place to be on the phone. Then text messaging is one of those things that we've actually been quite amazed by. A lot of our customers who start using text messaging at first are wowed by it. And then they start sending emojis to their patients. Something that, I mean, you would think, well, that's not professional, but it turns out patients want you to be real with them. They want to have fun with you. And we have a number of dental practices that they will schedule appointments on the phone, and then other patients, they're scheduling the appointment all via text messaging, never once getting on the phone with that patient. So you look at text messaging and the adoption, it needs to be more readily adopted all the way across and not looked at it as a tool just to confirm appointments.
And I'll add to that, Brandon, you know, the first wave of text messaging functionality in a dental practice was pretty much broadcast one-way communication. Yep. You know, in other words, we shot it out, hope like heck nobody ever responded back. Well, initially, there was no mechanism for them to respond back. And that really isn't how we use text messaging. We use it as a way to efficiently communicate back and forth. And your functionality is full-featured text messaging. Like I said, I love the idea of sending emojis. And again, that wouldn't be appropriate for every patient, but for many it is, isn't it?
Yeah. Everyone likes to get a smiley face.
I know. It's crazy. It's crazy. So can I be a devil's advocate for just a minute?
Sure.
So some might think that, wait a minute, if a patient can text back too easily, it might create more cancellations. It might be too, oh, I can't make it today. And they might shoot back a cancellation. I don't believe that, by the way, but some might think that. What are your thoughts about that?
So would you rather them just not show up or let you know they're not coming in advance?
Exactly.
So, and would you rather, if they let you know in advance they're not coming, be able to reschedule them right at that exact same time?
Right.
I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer.
I love it. I really love it because you're absolutely right. I don't. You know, I don't wish that that patient, you know, cancels or changes their appointment, but I'd rather know ahead of time than have them not show up. A no-show is really tough, Brandon. You know that in a dental office, unless we have someone in the building that we can bring in for a no-show. That's tough. But if I get enough advance notice, I even get an hour advance notice, the likelihood to fill that goes up dramatically.
Exactly.
Talk to me about the Weave app. You know, apps are part of our daily life these days. You know, I look at my phone and it's filled with apps that are appropriate to me and that I've chosen to make my life more efficient or more interesting. Talk about the Weave app.
Yeah. So we have, you know, the desktop software. We have that component that works when you're in the dental practice working, you know, during regular hours. We then also have a companion iPhone and Android app that works almost identical to the desktop app. And what this does is it gives you every single bit of functionality that Weave has from anywhere you have a cell phone connection. So that means you can receive calls from your patients, not on your personal cell phone number, but from your office number. Patients call your office. You can answer from your cell phone if you want to, if you're not in the office. You can text with patients from outside of the office. Once again, never giving out your personal cell phone number.
See, that's important. Brent, can I share with you how we discover this in my own practice?
Yeah.
So we love the idea of our doctor calling patients on the evening of treatment, and Paul and Tim will call any patient that got an injection. So if you were in our office today and you got an injection, you're going to get a call from Paul about 7 o'clock in the evening. About 85% of those go to voicemail, by the way. I actually wish 100% of them did, but but about 85% of them. And the message is going to be something like this. Hey, Brandon, this is Dr. Paul Nielsen calling. I like to call my patients on the evening of treatment. I was just calling to see how well you're doing. Listen, no need to return my call. I just wanted to check in with you. Hey, you mentioned you were going to your son's Little League game today. Hope you won that Little League game. Hey, I'll see you on your next visit. Okay, in the past, when we did that from Paul's personal phone, cell phone, guess what happened?
His cell phone would blow up.
His cell phone would blow up because patients would store that and they would literally blow up, you know, his phone in the future with future communications. So with your service, that doesn't happen.
Nope, it doesn't happen. And also, you imagine the amount of time it would take to call all of those patients back individually that leave a voicemail trying to get back in touch. And then the next day, you have another list of patients. Imagine if your team members could help listen to those voicemails and call those patients back that needed to be called back. So that's what the mobile app and the desktop app, how they work together. So a patient calls the doctor back saying, hey, thanks for calling. I have a couple questions. You know, give me a call back when you can. Well, the other team members, when they get into the office the next morning, they're going to see those voicemails on Weave and they can call those patients back immediately without saying, hey, doctor, do you have any voicemails on your cell phone? Can I see your cell phone, you know, and listen to those so I know who to call back? Mm-hmm. It just streamlines that whole process.
Makes it a lot more efficient. And in the same way, you know, I like to think that Paul and Tim have very good memories. When you have literally thousands of patients, you simply can't remember all that stuff. And, I mean, it'd be great, you know, if he was calling me, it would be great for Paul to be able to say, hey, I noticed that we have Therese coming in next week for her appointment. Tell her I said hello and looking forward to seeing her, you know, and that information's all there on your app screen.
Yep. Exactly.
So, and again, I like to think that we can manage that through our memory, but that just isn't possible, is it?
It's not.
Yeah.
Nope.
Yeah, love it. Hey, as you look into the future, what's coming down the pike with Weave? You guys are constantly innovating, constantly adding new features. What's coming down the pike?
Yeah, so I'm going to be the first one to say that despite how much I love what we're doing and despite the awesome feedback that we get from all of the dental practices that use us, you know, we are not perfect by any means. And, you know, the perfection is a journey. We are always adding features, just as you mentioned. We are tweaking things, improving things. And that's one of the things our customers love the best about us. So a couple of the things coming down the pipeline right now, I mentioned text to pay as being one of the easiest ways to collect payments from patients by just simply sending them a text message. We have another feature coming out soon called Team Chat. This is an easy way for your team members to chat back and forth within the Weave app. What we found was we had employees texting each other from within the Weave app, or they would have a separate chat window open to talk back and forth. And so we thought it just makes sense to put it all in one place, make it more accessible from either the desktop or the mobile app. So those are two really big features that are coming out. In the second half of 2018, we are going to be focusing heavily on revisiting how we approached a lot of the other features in the past and looking at tweaking and improving those, which is going to be extremely exciting. So it's that same thing if you've got to get patients and you got to keep patients. Right. So we have to add features and we have to then improve existing features. And so it's making sure you focus on both areas, and that's what we're going to be doing.
Can I ask you a question about a specific functionality?
Please do.
Is call recording a functionality within Weave?
It is.
So let's talk about that for a minute.
Yeah.
I'm a pretty strong believer. I'm gonna make a very bold statement, Brandon, and you are welcome to disagree with me. There's room for other opinions here. But I'm gonna make this statement. Doctors, if you are not recording your calls, you actually don't know what's being said on those calls, and you might be surprised. Is that an accurate statement, Brandon?
I would tell you that not just surprised, but shocked. So I remember one dentist specifically, a week after signing up, she sent me an email saying, "Holy cow, I had no idea what was being said on the phones, and I am shocked."
Yeah, and I want to be really cryptic about this. I am not trying to shame any dental team members, or I'm not trying to use the recording as a club. Absolutely not. Doctors, you have wonderful, wonderful, wonderful team members. And in many cases, we simply haven't invested in the proper training. And man, that's a tough job. So I want to emphasize that recording calls is not meant to be a club. Would you agree with that, Brandon?
Completely. And that's exactly what she said after. She's like, "I need to train my team members."
Yeah.
Because it wasn't consistent with what she thought she wanted, you know, how she communicated with people. And there's just disconnect.
May I give an example just last week a coaching call that I did with one of our clients in regards to listening to phone calls?
Yep, go for it.
So this was literally last week. And there were six calls altogether that I reviewed. And four of them I chose because they were really good. And so I was able to compliment the team member on very specific things that she did brilliantly on these calls. There were four of them. There were two that needed a little work. And it was the way I kind of look at it, it's kind of like a football coach watching game film. All right. We won the game, right? But we always want to get better, right?
Exactly.
So these two that needed work, the first one was nothing she said wrong. It was the tone of her voice. And I literally played the call, and within 10 seconds, she said, "Oh my gosh, I don't even sound friendly in that call." And did I need to say anything, Brandon? She's self-diagnosed. No. And you know, I came to her defense. I said, you know what? I totally understand. I bet at the same time, three other phone lines were ringing. You had two patients in front of you checking in. You had three in front of you checking out. And I get it. And she said, yeah, I know, but I've got to figure out how to remain friendly on the phone when the wheels are falling off. So you don't use the coaching, like I said, as a club. You use it to reinforce the positive things you want to have happen. And I love the way that you do that through recording. You actually make it a very seamless process to record the calls. And legal. Seamless and legal.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah. Hey, as we're coming into the home stretch here, I want to take a minute and kind of recognize your leadership, Brandon. I've had the privilege of visiting your offices many times. In fact, I believe I've been to four different Weave offices, four different Weave headquarters in the last 4 years. Would that be a proper count?
I believe it is. And that's not because we've been kicked out of our places.
Right. Yeah. Let me emphasize. Yeah.
Let me make that clear.
Yeah. Thank you for clarifying that. It wasn't that you didn't pay your lease payments. It was because you outgrew it. What's your head count today, if you don't mind me? What's your head count at headquarters today?
So we are headquartered in Lehigh, Utah, which is about 30 minutes south of Salt Lake City. And current headcount today is about, 185 employees as of today, but we are adding, I want to say, close to 10 employees a month right now, to the team. We are growing extremely quickly.
The area that you're in Lehigh has earned a wonderful nickname. We're all familiar with Silicon Valley, right? And yep. The area in Utah where you are has been nicknamed Silicon Slopes.
Yeah.
So how cool is that?
It's awesome. It's amazing the kind of technology and products that are being built here in Utah.
Hey, I want to recognize your leadership because you've got a very cool office, first of all. It really is an office that I think of in terms of 2018 and beyond. You've got all kinds of creative workspaces. Now, this doesn't apply to me, of course, Brandon, but your team members can get their hair cut in your office as well.
Yeah. So we do have a full-time stylist and a small little barbershop. So employees are invited to get their haircut whenever they want. They don't need to leave the office or worry about it. So it's been awesome.
Your stylist did help me out a little bit last visit by powdering my head so it wouldn't reflect when we did some videos. So I appreciated that.
Yeah, that's awesome.
But hey, Brandon, I want to recognize you for some of the cool things that you do in terms of creating a work environment that allows you to bring the best out of your team members. You do an awesome job of that. And there's all kinds of different things that you do that make coming to work at Weave a pleasure for your 185 plus team members. So way to go, man.
Thank you so much. It's an absolute blast to be able to work with these kinds of people, and everyone deeply cares about everything, about the product, about our customers, about dentistry, about your patients. It's one of our core values is to be caring. And that's probably the thing that resonates the strongest throughout our organization. And it just makes it a joy to come in. And people like you, when you guys come in, everyone seems to comment about it. And it's awesome to see that. So I really appreciate that. We work hard at it.
It's real and it's genuine and it's awesome. Brandon, I think maybe the best thing to do for our listeners would be to invite them to get a demo. Where can they get that?
So you can go to getweave.com. That's GETWEAVE.com. And you can peruse the website. There's a couple links on there to schedule a demo. We have employees who will reach out to you right away and get you scheduled. Demos can take as little as 10 minutes. Most people like to spend 30 to 45 minutes to kind of see everything. But typically when people see it, they're just blown away. And one of the amazing things about this, about Weave is something you're already paying for in some form. Meaning you pay for phone service, but you're not getting the features that Weave has. So when you sign up for Weave, you actually cancel your existing phone company. So whatever you're paying for that, that goes, that reduces what we've actually cost. So it's amazing. I'd encourage you to see a demo. We love showing everyone what we've built.
I'm glad you clarified that pricing because, now it depends what features and everything. There's lots of variables here, but, generally when a dentist makes an investment in Weave, he or she is not adding another expense. They're simply displacing one that they have now in their phone service with one that actually is turbocharged.
Exactly. Yep.
Yeah.
That's exactly the idea.
So, hey, I'm going to put a link in the show notes. So if you'd like to get a demo, I'll put a link in the show notes. The show notes are available at thrivingdentist.com. So don't take your hands off the wheel. When you get home, go to thrivingdentist.com and you can scroll down and there'll be a link for you to get a demo for Weave. I would strongly encourage you to do that. It's absolutely amazing. I believe when you see it, you'll have the same reaction that I had when I saw it 4 years ago, which is, oh my gosh, where has Weave been all my life? You know, this is amazing. So, also, Brandon and his team have put together a cool resource, a white paper with lots more information about retention and lifetime value of patient, all kinds of information. I'll put a link to that resource in the show notes as well. And really want to encourage you to get all this information, share it with your team members, and really utilize, I'll bring this back full circle, the most important piece of equipment in your office, which today is the telephone. And you finally have a way to use the telephone circa 2018 with all of the cool technology that goes along with it. I love the way you described it as a smartphone for your office. That's really what it is.
Yeah. Thank you, Gary. This was great.
Hey, Brandon, I want to thank you for all that you do. Thank you for your leadership. Thank you for your vision. Thanks for your friendship. I always enjoy coming to see you. Enjoy the office. Enjoy working with you. And thanks for all that you do, man.
Thank you, Gary. And I'm looking forward to seeing you again. We got some fun things to show you at our office.
I'm going to see you in July. We have a meeting coming up together. I'm going to see you in a couple months and very much looking forward to that.
That's awesome.
Hey, I also want to take a minute and thank our listeners. We sure appreciate you here at the Thriving Dentist Show. There's three things you can do to support our work. Number one, you can tell a colleague. You may know a dentist that's never heard the word podcast. Tell them about podcasts and tell them about the Thriving Dentist Show. Second thing you can do is you can jump on iTunes and write us a review. A review for us on iTunes works very much like a Google review works for your practice. And the third thing you can do is you can hit the subscribe button. If you hit the subscribe button, that means every Wednesday when we upload a new show, it'll be automatically uploaded to your listening device and you'll never miss a future show. It's free, and would encourage you to subscribe. On that note, let me take a minute and thank you for the privilege of your time and tell you I will look forward to connecting with you on the next Thriving Dentist Show.
When you cry, be sure to dry your eyes, 'cause better days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure smile wide, and don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride. Don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. When you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream big.